There's something rising above the dry, leaf-like scent of book and ink. Something infinitely softer, but more noticeable because it's so fine. I lift my nose to the air and I inhale, closing my eyes. Soft white flowers. Little blossoms unfurling. The very beginning scent of spring. That's what I smell when I close my eyes. Something so light and lovely that I'm a little taken aback by it. It's a perfume, that much I can tell, and I should be used to smelling perfumes in public spaces. But this one is somehow different. Maybe because beneath the gentle white tones of the flowers, there's something more. The warmth of skin, of a woman's skin. Immediately, my eyes are open again, and I'm glancing down the aisle to my right. But there's no one there. The perfume eludes me as I place one foot in front of the other, led through the bookshop by this bewitching scent. I round the corner of the final aisle, and there she is. A blonde woman, standing on a step stool, straining to reach the top shelf for, I assume, a particular book. She's wearing black flats and is standing on tiptoe at the very edge of the stool, causing the stool to tilt precariously, supporting itself on two legs instead of the usual four. She's leaning far forward, her long fingers straining to reach the spine of a just-out-of-reach book. Within seconds, I take in the fact that the woman wears a black pencil skirt that follows the curves of her rear and thighs with such precision that my eyes can't help but trace her shape. A satin cream blouse is tucked into the skirt, or it would be, but since she's straining so high to reach the book, the front of the blouse has come untucked, showing off the pale skin of her stomach. Her blonde hair falls around her shoulders in soft ringlets, and even though the hallway is darker than the rest of the shop, I can just make out that she's wearing a dark red lipstick as she frowns, leaning forward. I clear my throat, and I take a step toward her. "Can I help you?" I ask, but then everything happens very quickly because the woman is startled by my voice and her flat slips on the step stool, and then she begins to fall to the right with a sharp gasp. I don't think. I simply act. I'm lunging forward, and then all of the time I've spent at the gym pays off because, wonder of wonders, I actually catch her out of midair. She stares up at me from my arms, surprised, her full mouth, which is wearing this really gorgeous dark red lipstick, in a round O of astonishment, and I'm about to say something, but the book that this woman is reaching for on the shelf apparently came loose when she took a tumble because something very hard smacks my head. It was so damn unexpected that I, completely embarrassed to admit this, by the way, topple myself, and then we're both lying crumpled on the bookstore floor. The woman sits up quickly and glances at me in shock, leaning forward. I know I shouldn't be noticing this kind of stuff right now, but her long blonde hair falls over her shoulder toward me, and with it comes that light floral scent. I inhale deeply, then groan a little, putting my hand to my forehead. "Oh my God, are you okay?" she asks me. I can tell that her voice is normally warm, but right now she sounds alarmed. I don't want her to be alarmed. It was just a clock to the head, so I sit up and smile at her, knocking my forehead with my knuckles. I inherited my ma's thick skull. No worries. We were apparently more entangled in each other's limbs than I first recognized because she tries to get up, but her long legs in their black tights are tangled up in mine. As I try to get up to help her, my arm ends up grazing her bare stomach. Her shirt got pushed up when she fell, and she tugs it down now with an apologetic smile, but I'm realizing that I'm feeling kind of warm and dizzy. It's not from the hit on the head, right? I mean, the world only began whirling when I touched her skin. Her soft, floral-perfumed, warm skin. The woman picks up the book that hit me, and she offers me a hand, which I take. And then we're both standing together. She laughs, shaking her head apologetically. I feel so stupid right now. I could lie and say that I'm normally graceful.